You better believe a nigga got you. Yeah, I stay doped up, 25-8 like wire. I got chicks like Queen twerk around me. And you know they bad, so you better believe a nigga got you. Yeah, I stay doped up.
Because he's going now into he's going to become one of us. Yeah. You understand? So, yay. Whatever. We will search you everywhere. You will even in your yay. Don't this guy have a knife here?
Me, as I'm standing here, I'm a product of bad decisions that I made in the past.
We were always looking. He was an American gangster. He was one of the hitmen, then Leivas. So he told me that if I can kill that person, that he can you can give me a 10,000 rand.
I used to belong to the JFK gang. They are a well-known gang in Bontebal. They're well-known because they like to kill people, they like to shoot people. And I was one of the guys who used to kill and shoot people.
Hey, birds get fly for the bread in the township. If I made 100 with the feds, know about it.
Well, as soon as we came to Cape Town, met up with all the ex-gang members. And we were, they were basically telling us about their life story and how they, what sort of things they did in the gang and how they got out of that sort of lifestyle. As soon as we walked in, it was really scary because it was an experience that we've never felt before and never properly experienced. But then once you got to know them, they were absolutely down to earth and very, very nice guys.
And that guy just pulled out the gun and he just started to shoot. And he was hitting the second time, and I was, yeah, you're shooting nonsense, man. And the time when he shoot the third time, I was lifting my jacket, but I didn't have a gun, I just to make him scared. And he was so shocked, and he began to run.
It was an experience that is once in a lifetime. Just seeing them people, knowing what they've done in the past, it's, you take life for granted, to be fair, because for all I knew, they could have still been in the gang, and they could have been ordered to do something terrible to our group.
I was 14 years old when I entered the gang. On the age of 15, 16, I shot the first guy. On the age of 16, 17, I killed the first person.
It was just mad to see, like, they don't care about you telling how many people they've killed, they're, what they've done. They're not ashamed to say, we've killed someone, we have done this and we have done that. It's just, some of them actually seem proud of killing people. So it makes me feel insecure a wee bit, that knowing these people have killed people and potentially could kill us even. But I don't think that would happen, like, but it's just still a fear factor.
Oh, but where we're going now is the corner where I was shot 5 times, we're going to that corner now. What made it happen is because of the gang I used to belong to. Because I was active in a gang and I also used to shoot people. And that's why people came back to me and started shooting me. I was walking here. The guy came from across the road. I was talking to a few guys and they was just started shooting at me. And as they shot me, I ran around the corner to one of my friend's houses, and there's where I sit it, and a car came, and the car took me to hospital. This is my friend that I used to go with, running around with nonsense gang, guns and so on. He was the guy who, out of all the guys you saw now, they wasn't there that time, but he was the one who was there with me all the times.
I'm a writer guy, man. A lot of people will like me, man. You see, because I'm always somebody can talk to with these problems, and I like to help them. So I like to help people and all that, man. We shoot and we sell drugs and all that stuff. He is an inspiration to a lot of us to look up, man. Just as an example, there is a way out also if you want to search.
As you heard, very genuine guy. A guy that you can speak to, a guy that you will be able to listen to you. He's a very good decision-making guy.
Tonight we met actual gang members who are involved in gangs at the moment. And very, very scary. They came in, they spoke to us about what gang they're in and stuff like that there. And The Rebels we look at is a gang called the Dixie Boys. They buy one of their friends a day, which one of the Dixie Boys shot.
If you would see us together, man, you would think we are gays or something, because we even, like the guy we lost, the friend we lost, we were crying on each other's shoulders and stuff.
I was not expecting what I was in for. I came in here and I was scared at the start, and I was like, there's no point being scared. I'm with people here who know them. I'm going to be 100%. But they came in and they took a gun out, and I was not expecting them to take a gun out. Like,
how long have you been in the game?
Yeah, 17 years. I was 14 years. I go in the game.
As soon as I was walking in the room, I thought I was done that day. I thought I was just gonna, they were gonna come in and shoot the place up, and I was me done.
it's a fact to me tonight, because they've took the season too quick and jumped into it, instead of sitting back and thinking about the seasons they're making and what they've got getting themselves into. So I would all, until the next few seasons, I'm gonna have to sit and think about it and think long and hard that it is, if is it the right decision to make, or is it not the right decision to make?
2, 3, 4, I can't even remember.
They have guns on them 24/7, and one of them actually addressed their gun as their buddy. They say, my gun is my buddy and I carry it everywhere. So it just shows you the life they live around here.
Knowing that these men have done terrible things, and how they're all so calm about it. It's like talking about the weapons and talking about the drugs, just, it really does make you think a bit more. Choices are key now in life, in my opinion. Like, the smallest things could change your future in dramatic ways.
It's all about really what you want, what your heart wants, and you shouldn't be judged, or you shouldn't follow sheep because your friends drink. You shouldn't drink, or because any different Axeman said, and I learned that tonight.